Well, well, well. Look who's ready to resume their lessons. I'm sure this has nothing to do with you bombing the local talent show last weekend. I believe you may have forgotten the most important lesson I've taught you, making sure not to suck. Ah, that's all right. You know, I think you may just need some fresh material. I guess we'll start with some improvisation. And don't forget, my little sugar lump, to reveal the music that really makes you dream, you must not play the music, but the dream itself. I'll give you a tempo. Come in whenever you're ready.
And now, our feature presentation.
Birds flying high, you know how I feel. Sun in the sky, you know how I feel. Breeze drifting on by, you know how I feel. It's a new dawn, it's a new day. It's a new life for me, yeah. It's a new dawn, it's a new day. It's a new life for me. Ooh. And I'm feeling good.
Thank you. They do have just two rules with ships and bottles. And the first one is no fair breaking or cutting the bottle. And the second rule is no fair using mayonnaise or pickle jars. So ultimately, everything has to go in through the opening. And that's the real trick. My dad, he was an engineer, and his job was problem solving. And so that's what keeps me going, is that constant, how do I solve this? It's all scratch built, they're not from kits or anything. So I've got to make each piece and really study the subject matter pretty well. I like getting the reaction. And especially if it has sentimental value, historical value, and somebody says, wow, you really nailed it, you really got it right. I like doing the detailed scenes because people's imaginations can kind of run wild. They can pretend they're a pirate if they have a pirate ship, or they're in the tea trade if they have Cutty Sark. The enjoyment is, I know that when people have these and they're looking at them, when I'm looking at them, is it kind of takes you away to that other world that's in that little glass bottle.
Softly with curled lips. I realized once I got out of the hospital that we are one. This really changed me.
Ever since I can remember, since I was young, my father has had ringing in his ears and Meniere's disease. So he gets very dizzy, gets very sick with it. And I've seen him in and out of hospitals where they couldn't do anything for him. So witnessing his struggle and how he's been let down by the Western medicine has really made us both focus on other sources of healing. I've had the experience with some people explaining that it felt like surgery, not in a real painful way, but in a taking out of the body kind of a way. So this energy is kind of being pulled out. And then once I pull that out, I put in the opposite. So I send the energy into the body and the stomach, then I go to the head. At the head, we're releasing guilt and we're imprinting innocence. And then I work on the third eye. And from there, we release distrust and imprint trust. I work on the throat. In the throat, we release shame and we imprint spiritual pride. We release from the shoulders shoulds. And there, I imprint freedom. Then we go to the sides of the body and we release resentment and anger and imprint forgiveness. And then I do the feet to ground. Something I like to tell people is that this is a healing thing. This isn't just some kind of therapeutic like massage. It's not meant to make you feel good. It's meant for you to heal. Healing can be kind of messy sometimes. I've had clients that call me the next day and say, I just had my session yesterday. Why don't I feel good? Like, I've been crying all day. And I said, good, you should be crying all day. Because it's the relief.
Thank you.
Jennifer has always been, I'd have to say, for me, it's like an earth angel. She always seems to point me in the right direction when I'm not always going in the right direction.
We're on the same page, finally. Trying to do the same thing.
Not so much living from the head as the heart.
Part of what led me to the healing was my own suffering.
I don't think she ever had confidence in her abilities of what she could do until she found healing.
I did struggle for, I would say, my entire life with anxiety and fear. It was very frustrating because there wasn't a lot anybody could do for me. And that's part of what turned me to the holistic healing realm because of really bad experiences with doctors and medications and things like that.
I don't think that Western medicine has all the answers. I really don't. You get to the point where, you know, you've got to say, this just can't be the only way to do this. I'm a Reiki master. I do implement other modalities. I try to learn from as many different sources as I can instead of sticking with one to heal. It's all energy. It's all God's energy.
I see him battling between the religion and this new healing that he's found.
My parents were brought up strict Catholics. For me, when I was in church, it seemed to be just ceremonial. They made you feel as though you're a sinner and you're bad. I think I knew at an early age that there's something wasn't right there for me. I still have that deep connection, but I'm realizing that I am no longer religious, I'm spiritual. I comfort myself with what I can do now, you know? I'm doing this more for other people than I'm doing it for myself, although it didn't start that way. It started with me wanting to just feel better. I had suffered so much with my head and the other problems that I've had that I don't want anybody to go through any part of what I've gone through, no part of it. I don't have any regrets for trying to help somebody. I would have a regret if what I was trying to do was mislead somebody. Then I would, but I don't.
Sorry, it's really hard to play loud because I don't want to be like bang, 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 bang.
Bang, bang.
Oh, 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 oh. Okay.
Okay, let's do another take two and a snap.
Okay. Take two.
It's sad that
And all we ever had faded right back in the dust. There were people crying, flashes on the horizon. Where were you the night the Republic fell? Were you by yourself, kicking pebbles in the frozen ground? Oh, it was just a dream, the best we'd ever seen.
We had a tent. That was it. We traveled by canoe. I think we spent 3 weeks in the canoes. We had about a week's supply of clothes, which you kind of washed in the river and stuff. The river was pretty cold. It's a very unusual time. It was 24-hour sunlight. What I think interested me the most in Alaska, back then it really was the last frontier. We went down there and went to Alaska and met up with my aunt, DeFrancis, and all four of us went on to Woodchopper Creek. where my grandfather's gold mine was, that we wanted to see Grandpa's deal. You know, we wanted to follow what he did. Before World War II, my grandfather got out of Germany and was working on a whaling ship and jumped ship. And like many people, there was a gold rush at the time, and they making their way to Alaska. So you went up to Chilicon Pass. Many people went to Anchorage, and he went to Whitehorse. He didn't drink, but everybody kind of hangs out in the saloon. And he always took a cigar. And a guy noticed that and came over to him one day and offered him ownership in a gold mine as his partner. They pay in gold for probably, I think it was about 6-7 years. Then he packed up and got married to my grandmother, and we moved up here from the city in Bronx, bought a farm, and we become farmers.
Look at all of them now.
How much of the frontier is left now, I have no idea. Frontiers are disappearing. Nobody really cares about the frontier. They all want a piece of the frontier. So they don't live in harmony with it. They create their own frontier. So they're paying dearly prices for chunks of land that are really, they might visit once a year. And it's created a firestorm of development.
Yeah, no, that's not quite right. That's ripe. Yummy.
I'd like to go back. I'm 65 now. If I don't do it soon, I ain't going to be doing it. I like fishing. I like hunting. I wished I could do that again. I would like to experience what Alaska people experience.
Go downtown and look some stranger in the face. I wanna be myself again. Remember why I left this place. I wanna wake up now and squeeze the living from this day. I wanna believe truly everything's gonna be okay. But I'm only human now. I'm as vacant as a drum. Won't you tell me I may learn to be overcome? I wanna feel clean.
Vacant.
speak up to be heard. Sometimes it's even louder to find some quiet in a word. Don't let them change you, kid. That's what somebody said to me, but you know it gets harder to hear myself over all this humanity.
About, so I'm looking for something to put in my mouth. Feels like I lost a friend, but you still wear the same old shirt that you wore back then. Writing your thoughts in the dark, you can that paper so you carry a mark. Inventing new language with some energy you don't have. Does it exist? I'm sorry to break your shell, had a few drinks, my friend. Now I know you too well. Trying to see right through, can you help me remember the things that I love about you? What I love about you. Thank you. put in my mouth. Feels like I lost a friend, but you still wear that same old smile that you wore back.
It's, actually, I've only gone to homeschool formals. So.
It's like the prom homeschoolers.
People kind of awkwardly dance. Not near as much dirty dancing as I would expect at a public school.
You have people smoking weed in the bathrooms and they get caught. People making out behind the curtains.
It's just a cliche. It's a fun cliche.
It's like where you go and you dance, but you don't know how to dance.
You always end on, can't stop. No, don't stop believing.
Yeah. So for me, it's a little bit like, we're middle schoolers, a bunch of middle schoolers. Gross.
But I think overall, it's just, you know, a bunch of awkward teenagers all in one room.
What could go wrong?
What could go wrong?
Go up the mountain.
I go
maybe?
Back to where the tracks were.
Oh yeah, I did suggest that also. Yeah, follow the tracks.
Make a nature check.
All of us.
Orb, Shadow of the Night.
Chromatic orb. It says I need a gem worth 50 GP. Can I just have that?
So what's going on right now?
Oh, he's shaving the back of my neck because I got a haircut. Don't I slice see. My lymph nodes.
Nope.
That would make me cry a little bit. Yeah, there's hair on the back of my neck, and I need him to shave it off.
You wouldn't want your date seeing that?
Right.
So tell me what's significant about this formal. Just pretend you're talking to me as a friend.
Okay.
Not as a professional colleague.
Yeah, one of my classmates asked me the formal, and also asked another guy, so she's going with both of us.
How do you feel about that?
It's a little whack.
Okay, you're done.
Epic.
Okay, James... What are you about to do here?
Put my fingers around my ankle.
Okay.
And connect them. Like that.
Wow.
Let me see the connection. Make it down.
Rubbing them together. Wow. They're touching.
That is incredible, man.
Yeah, I don't know anyone else who can do that.
That's what makes you special in the world.
Yep, that's what makes me Spider-Man.
Okay, so talk a little bit about your friend Cayman.
Yeah, my friend Cayman, he's a senior, and this will be his last formal, and he's a pretty cool guy. He's like the next stage of human evolution. He's cut away everything that is not necessary. He's the most efficient man alive. He watches movies on times 2 speed, because it's the same information anyway.
So tell me about you and Cayman's friendship.
We've been friends for a good couple of years now. When we hang out, it involves us getting in the car and sitting there for a while trying to decide what to do because we both have a fear of making decisions.
Mm.
We both make music. We still never made a song together. We've talked about it, but we still never gotten around to it.
Mm-hmm.
Gotta do that before he leaves.
Where's he going?
He's gonna go to college this fall, I think.
So that's what makes this formal special.
Gonna be his last one.
Can you talk about your first formal experience?
I sat in the same chair the whole time. I never danced or anything.
So this has been a growth experience for you.
It has. At the spring formal, June 8th, 2018, mm-hmm. I tried to talk to a girl,
mm-hmm.
and we made plans for how I was gonna talk to her like the entire night.
Mm-hmm.
Then finally we were like, let's just go talk to her, I guess. So it was towards the end of the night, I was walking over to her table to go talk to her.
Uh-huh.
She picked up her bag and left.
Oh.
I went home and cried.
You'd actually cried?
I might have, I don't remember for sure.
Yeah. Now you're not afraid of anything.
I'm a big boy now.
Yes, you are. This is the before.
Yes.
Oh yeah, ready to go. So, I've heard there is a pact between you and Asher and Cayman for tonight.
Indeed. yeah, we all agreed that we're gonna have to dance and probably talk to a rando at some point tonight. I came up with it. We basically promised to do that every year. I don't think I've probably ever really done it. Kamen might have, but yeah, it's something we gotta do.
Nice.
I just leave it always tied so I can just put it on and tighten it.
Are you nervous?
A little. It's probably because I haven't processed the idea of talking to a rando girl yet.
Don't worry about it. So, Dosa.
Yes.
Did you coordinate this whole thing?
I did.
Okay, how many formals have you coordinated?
I believe 6 now. Well, you probably have the kids who have been here before who are just excited to be with their friends, hang out, eat food, and pay only $10 for all of it. Then you have others who have never been here before. They're probably really nervous about social interaction and being with people they don't know and a sweaty dance floor. Mm-hmm. But I think all around, it's just, once you get into it, it's a lot of excitement.
I got a book on me.
Hey, Kamen, how's it going? Was that you when you came in earlier?
Yeah, and then I just thought to do the duo.
This is Kamen. Say hi, Kamen.
So, hi.
No, you're a part of this.
You're actually kind of the main character of this.
I mean, I kind of expected that.
I'm making a short documentary about the formal tonight.
Cool.
I've heard this is your last formal.
That's right.
How are you feeling about that?
It's fine.
So explain why you take the trash out.
So that it doesn't overflow.
Explain why you're the person taking the trash out.
Oh. Because I work here.
Okay, yeah. Are you taking any girls tonight?
No. Because I want to be free.
You want to be free?
Not stuck with somebody the whole night.
You want to be free to sow your wild oats.
Yes.
I'll catch up with you later at the formal. I gotta go with James on his weird date. You're the hero of this story.
I'm the protagonist of my own life.
True.
That's from an anime, Mob Psycho 100. Good show.
How's it going?
It's going great.
Good. Just pretend I'm not even here.
I'm Belle.
Belle.
Trey.
Trey.
Jared.
Jared. How's that spelled?
J-A-R-R-O-D.
Okay, awesome. And how did you meet James?
I met him at Elevate. It was so fun. American history class was awesome.
Are you excited for this formal?
Oh, yes.
Have you been to one before?
Many. Let's see. I've been to Trailblazer spring formal one time. That was a while ago.
Uh-huh.
Winter formal twice.
Okay.
And one Elevate formal before this one.
Have they all been wonderful?
Yes.
No bad experiences?
Nah.
So it's your first formal. How are you feeling right now?
A little nervous. It's also my first date.
Oh, okay. Who are you taking?
Oh, her name's Mira. She's about this tall.
Okay.
She's 14.
Okay.
She's nice.
That's important.
And she's good at school.
Good at school? So she's smart too?
Yes.
So Jared, tell me about your tie.
Oh, the tie? It's called the Linwood Taurus knot. Now most of these like new ties are like tied with the little end.
Okay.
Back here.
Okay.
But this one's tied with the big end, and this one requires a lot of the tie. If it's not tall enough for you, you're gonna have to like buy like a tie that's like super long.
Gotcha.
Well, I think it's great to see a lot of young people together that have similar values, and it's good that they can build upon friendships in some way other than just around a textbook.
So how do you feel about this being your son's first formal?
It's a bit different because I never went to one when I was growing up.
Me neither.
So I remember being that age and meeting a young lady for the first time or whatever, and how nervous you get. Mm-hmm. What am I supposed to do? And am I doing this right? Did I comb my hair the right way? All that. I'm sure it'll be a good experience. Kind of work out the butterflies. It's better to do that at 14 than when you're certainly much older.
Thank you.
I can't tell what you're calling.
Hey, yo, you wanna dance? And she's like, hopefully sure, maybe no, I don't know. And I'll be like, I'm James, by the way, and maybe she'll tell me her name, she might not. And I'd be like, oh, so what kind of music do you listen to? I listen to a lot of music, so I can pretty much start a conversation with whatever she says. Hopefully she says emo, probably won't, but there's a chance. Then I'll just see from there, I guess.
Do you have a plan, Sean?
No. I don't really need a girlfriend because I've already got myself, really. So, like.
Good. Their song is Take On Me.
Oh, yeah, you guys need to get out there.
We have to. James, we gotta take on me.
How are you feeling just walking in right now?
It's great.
I'm asleep.
Describe how much you love
everything.
This song.
Everything. 10. I love this song. 1,000 hugs from 10,000 lightning bugs.
How's the dance going so far for you?
Great.
Great?
Uh-huh.
Good.
I don't think my full power is unlocked yet.
What?
I don't think my full power is unlocked yet.
What will that take for your full power to unlock?
Not even I know.
No one knows that.
Nobody knows.
Well, you're looking pretty good out there.
Yeah, hard work too.
You take dance classes?
Not really, no.
No, it's all natural?
Yeah.
Nice. You're good at moving.
Feel old.
It used to be you out there. What's the weirdest thing you've ever seen kids doing at a dance?
There was a supposed time that somebody was, you know, smoking the wacky tobacco, but I never saw it.
You just smelled it.
Yeah.
Okay, Ellie. When I was talking about my plan, the girl I'm planning on asking to dance walked through the hallway right when I was talking about it.
Hmm.
I think that's fate.
So you think she heard it?
I mean, maybe.
I didn't see her.
I mean, when she walked by, all I said is, and that is my plan.
Nice. Well, if it works, then I'll leave it in.
Okay. That's fair.
I doubt many people will watch this.
That's fair also. I say that's fair a lot. That's
you got it.
Organic, we'll do it.
Organic?
Yeah.
Okay.
I don't know how to dance, but it works.
So where's Mira?
Oh, somewhere.
Do you think you're actually gonna do it tonight?
if they play a slow song.
I would probably just wait for an opportune moment, because if she's with her friends, that's, you know, the pack, that's the wolf pack, and you can't break into the wolf pack. Sorry. Come in, Sean.
It's just Sean.
But, like, once she's alone, that's the moment you gotta look for. You gotta wait till she breaks away from the pack.
Yo, I'm James.
Yeah. And you should maybe, like, offer a gift, like you have a cookie or something, like, you want this cookie? Actually, that might be a bad idea.
I was gonna say that.
Once she breaks away from her friends and is walking to get a drink or something, that's when you swoop in.
What do I say?
I mean, this is your plan. I don't want to make it for you, but if I were you, I'd say, I'd probably start by complimenting her, you know? That's always an easy thing to walk up to her. So, something you like about her, maybe her shoes, be like, whoa, those are some cool shoes. Hey, I'm James, or something like that. Like, that's the easiest approach for me.
I'm James. Then I complain about the song.
Yeah, especially if it's like something really bad.
But what if she says it's her favorite song?
Then you say, oh yeah, me too.
All right, let's go, boys. Right,
let's pay your taxes.
Surely you weren't filming it.
Surely not.
All right, we're back.
I walk up and say, whoa, nice dress, I'm James, I hate this song, and I want to die.
I was like, also, I can go to the dance thing if you want. And she was like, yay! You don't have to if you don't want to, though. I don't want to force you. I said, I'll go if I can dance with you. You'll just show me how to.
Whoa.
And she said, perfect, I don't know how to either.
Dang,
so we're probably gonna not be very good at that. So I'm gonna tell you this story, how someone falls in love. You have these things inside your head called hormones.
Yep.
They're like chemicals in your brain.
Yep.
When you're young, your body just starts pumping them out like it's never done it before, because it hasn't. It's just like, I gotta make all the hormones.
Yeah.
And then you see, like, any person who, like, you see very often. That's of the opposite sex, usually.
Like Michelle Obama.
And then you're like, whoa.
Whoa.
That person is just, like, the most amazing person I've ever seen.
Yeah.
And then, like, something happens in your eyes. So these little shields come over your eyes. And you're not able to see all the things that are wrong with them.
Exactly.
So you're like, wow, man, that drug dealer boyfriend who, like, has a warrant out for his arrest.
Yeah.
Man, he is so hot.
I am so tired.
No.
I was just making some drama for the documentary.
Okay. How tired are you?
I don't know how I'm gonna do this. I need to find help.
This is your last drama.
Yeah.
That's a pretty good deal.
Yeah. I'm graduating.
You feel sad or happy?
No. Because most of the people here are like 14 and 15, so.
Spin me. Are you talking to your online girlfriend?
Yeah, you can't see her though. Think of like, I don't know, like the hottest girl in the world.
Okay.
And then that's her.
So, okay.
Yeah. I mean, like, nothing special, but you know.
Nothing,
I mean, I don't really need a whole lot, just like.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, she's pretty secretive and doesn't like to show her face a lot. I've never seen a picture of her, but she's described herself to me. So, like, yeah, I kind of understand. I think maybe that I'll get to meet her in, like, a couple of months. You know, get to meet her for real in real life.
Yeah, that'd be good.
Yeah, yeah, I'll take you along and you can meet her too. I think she'll be okay with it.
Sounds good.
Yeah, yeah.
You gonna go for it right now?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm gonna start by introducing myself.
Okay.
Okay.
You can do this.
I'm freaking out, man.
Do it.
She's just looking around.
Here we see a high school boy in his natural habitat.
Did you film our conversation?
I did.
Nice.
So?
Yeah, I walked up and was like, yo, I'm James. And she was like, oh, cool, I'm Anna. And I was like, I'm trying to remember the first thing I asked. I think it was, what kind of music do you like? We talked about that for a bit. And she was like, so do you like going to dances and stuff? And I was like, yeah, I guess so. Not very good at talking to people, so. And then I was like, you take classes with Eliza Elevate, right? And she was like, yeah, I take drama and art with her. And I was like, oh, nice. Friends with her brother over there is in a movie with her. And she's like, oh, yeah, we need to watch that. I'm going to watch it on YouTube soon. So,
nice. Yeah. Subscribe to Fireplace.
Yo.
Good, it's just Asher.
What are we doing?
We're just debriefing.
So then. Then we talked for rich random stuff, talked about art, lack of sleep, school, junk like that. It's pretty
nice.
Cool.
How do you feel now?
Epic. Gotta go dance with her.
Yeah, but you've got, it's a long night.
Yeah.
It's a long night.
I'm feeling pretty good about this. I went and made myself do it.
You did it, man.
Yeah, it was fun. I think it went well.
Hey, never again.
Never again. I enjoy talking to her.
Ashley, what about you?
What about me?
You gonna ask a girl or not?
I did dance with a girl.
What?
But it was really organic, so you missed it.
I missed it.
Yeah. Well, she had her. Her friend asked me.
Did her friend ask you out to dance, or did your friend ask?
She asked him, and then the other girl took him.
My sister's friend told me that her friend wanted to dance with me.
So you asked her, or she asked you?
She asked me, but I...
She was 13.
She was 13.
How old are you, Ashley?
16.
Oh my!
This is the part of the dance where I'm sick of all the music that they're playing. I think I'm just out of touch with like pop music.
So have you asked the girl to dance here?
Yeah, I danced with the girl. It was pretty fun. We talked about our favorite color and favorite animals and how we're bad at dancing.
Do you remember what her favorite color and animal was?
I do it for the kids.
Cool.
Yeah, just like to see them have a good night. Yeah, a lot of them don't have many friends. A lot of them don't have the money to pay $40, $50, $80 for a formal. And this gives them a great chance to interact with other people and just have a good time. Bye!
I was just still dancing around. And I don't know, something with me, I dance better when I look at my own shadow, so I can see what I'm doing.
Mm-hmm.
And so that kind of happened, and I'm feeling pumped.
What awakened?
Something.
Something?
Wild spirit, I guess.
You want to go out and show me?
Look at me! Why did we get the camera?
truth or dare, and I'm trying to not let them do anything dangerous.
Okay.
Okay. 55, 54, 53, 52.
The trick is, they don't know what this song is.
I mean, they heard it in a movie, and yeah, they apparently love it.
Circles around so we can give him thumbs up.
Tale of woe, James?
No. Well, not really. I felt really bad because the song Belle requested to dance with me with, the song I danced with her, the other girl, she was about to leave.
I
feel really bad.
Yeah.
That you assured me.
You win some, you lose some.
You can move in
closer. Oh yeah, we talked about Scott Pilgrim and Napoleon Dynamite, stuff like that.
So she's a nerd?
Yep, she also liked anime.
Uh-oh.
She took an ugly picture of herself and assigned it as her contact photo on my phone.
Nice.
So that's pretty good.
Nice. It keeps you real.
Is that you?
Yes.
It's why I gotta go talk to Bill.
Okay, you're a true man, James.
I apologize, she seemed unhappy. Rip.
That was a little whack, but then that went well, I'd say. I said, sorry, I was gonna dance with you on that one, but someone was about to leave that I was gonna try to dance with. I don't really know what else I could have said. I still feel kind of bad.
I had a really great experience.
Really?
Yeah.
You sat down for most of it.
Sometimes people watching is even better than being in the midst of people.
You're talking to the right guy.
What?
How was your last formal, man?
Fine. It was fine.
I gotta sing this song with you. It's not reality, kid. How do you think I'm fighting? It was only a kid. It was only a kid. That's all you see.
It's all in the crap. And he's having a smoke. And he's taking a drag. And he's going to win. And he's on the sick. And it's all in my head.
Do you have any closing thoughts or feelings or advice to anybody in your position?
Just walk towards the person you want to talk to, and then you're in an uncomfortable position where you have to talk to them. Peace.
Stop.
Get him.
My final thought.
Stop.
I was right. The miniskirts.
Thank you.
Ah, welcome back, scrub. Looks like you're quickly moving up the talent ranking. You should be good enough to embarrass yourself at the open mic any day now. For this lesson, we'll be learning Low Key by Adron, a bluesy sunset beach stroll in C major with a delightful hook. Now, the whirly is humming and ready to go, so let's get started. It starts with an eighth note on middle C. No, that's A. Now, don't forget, you can use your hotkeys. This song will have a few triads. So, middle C. No, I'm sorry, darling. That's a C, but not the one we want. Let's move an octave up. There we go. Now just a brief roll off the E-flat to the E. Brief roll. It's a grace note, not a white claw. Quit pounding it. Ah, very nice. You're trash. But you know what? That's okay. It's called a garbage can, not a garbage can't. Listen, don't overthink it. Just close your eyes, channel the musical cosmos, and the music plays itself. Remember, you are merely the conduit. Forward, directly concentrate all facets during conferences. What the devil? It's like some kind of managerial speak. Thank you.